You, I feel like, have been in two of the most beloved, iconic television shows of all time. Friday Night Lights, absolutely outstanding. And The Wire, and you were in The Wire as well.
Yep.
Now, are those shows people still approach you about all the time?
Yeah, it's crazy, man. I mean, to be a part of those shows that kind of stood the test of time and, you know, and meant so much to the fans. I mean, I get a Where's Wallace all the time when I'm walking down the street. Where's Wallace? I'm like, I'm right here. And then, you know, diehard, you know, Texas fans and diehard Friday Night Lights fans. Okay, all right, Texas in the building.
Do Friday Night Light fans want to ask you, like, how Vince's football career is going? Because when I see you, I do.
So where would you think Vince is, like, right now?
I mean, I guess I feel like Vince probably went to college.
College,
right?
Okay,
you know,
okay.
I think he played some college ball, but I don't think he made it to the pros. But okay. I feel like, you know, he's a happy person.
Yeah, he's definitely okay.
Yeah.
No, but a lot of fans, they always want to know, like where I'm at. So I'll tell him, I don't know, maybe he went to the NFL, maybe he didn't, I don't know. Maybe
it's weird that you're having conversations about a make-believe person.
He's kind of not alive.
Yeah,
he's kind of not real.
Wallace, of course, they don't ask that question because he's not alive, even fictionally.
Yeah.
Spoiler alert, they've had time to watch it, I feel like, at this point.
It's been a decade.
Yeah, it's more than a decade, yeah. But now, that sort of famously on shows, I feel like The Sopranos or The Wire, you know, these kind of shows, you're always at risk of finding out your character is not going to make it. Did you see this coming when you were on the show? How did they let you know?
Yeah, I mean, I was so young at the time, you know, and by season three, I think everybody kind of knew nobody was safe because we were dropping like flies. So, like, when we got the script, we would literally just skim through it just to make sure your name's at the end of the the script. And you're like, okay, cool, now I can go back and read it kind of casually. So right around the time Wallace started using drugs, I kind of figured he was going to get killed off maybe towards the end of the season. And then sure enough, you get that knock on your trailer from David Simon, and he's like, Mike, look, I love you, all right? Everybody on the cast love you. The fans, they love you. That's why we got to kill you.
Oh, no.
And it was like, you know, I thought my career was over. You know, at that age, you know, I kind of, like, you know, grew up around these guys, all these veteran actors and stuff
like
that.
How old were you in your first year?
I was 14.
God, man, that's crazy.
I was like 13, 14 right around that time. And you know, I thought my career was over, but they were like, no, Mike, you'll be fine. You're going to do other things. I'm like, how do you know that? You don't know. And they were just like, but I guess they knew something I didn't. So
yeah.
It was cool.
Are you prepared now, and has this happened yet, like being in one of these Marvel comic book movies? You know, obviously, you know, The Wire and, you know, Friday Night Lights, you weren't taking over something that existed before.
Yeah.
Have people already approached you about their own emotional connection to the Fantastic Four? Do you get that a lot?
Yeah, I mean, comic book fans are like, they're so passionate about, you know, what they love. They take ownership over these characters. They kind of grew up with them. And they just kind of, they want a good movie, you know, just as much as I want a good movie. So they definitely express that a lot. You know, I stay off of Twitter and Instagram as much as I can.
Right.
Yeah, it's just, you know, you just gotta like block all that stuff out. But they definitely express their passion, especially at Comic-Con, that they want a
good
movie.
Was that the first time you went to Comic-Con?
That was
my
first time, man. And it was massive. I mean, like, it was you just see all the costumes and all the, you know, all the fans out there on the floor.
It's really exciting to see people who are just so confident and so happy looking so weird. It's the
best. I mean, it's just like...
But you kind of go, yeah, why am I ever, you know,
not
in my head?
Costume,
these people
right?
are just living it up. It's great.
Yeah, stormtroopers in underwear. Like, it's just like, it's crazy. Stuff.
I will say, if you ever go back in one of your Human Torch suits, don't do the naked one. I think, like, on the floor, do one of the first two.
Yeah. It might be a little weird.
Seriously, it's such an honor to meet you. I think you're just a great actor, and I'm so happy you've got all this exciting stuff happening for you. Give it up, everybody, for Michael B. Jordan.